Hi everyone. Today we're going to see how to analyze a vehicle with a failure in the engine control system using IDC5 with HaynesPro, the database built into our self-diagnostic tool. The vehicle at issue has a failure in the engine control system, which can be easily recognized by the activation of the engine warning light and the lack of power. Let's proceed with the diagnosis using AXONE Nemo 2 in our diagnostic interface, TXT Multihub. We'll connect to the vehicle and launch a scan of all the electronic control units using the TGS3S function to see which errors were detected. In this case, failures have been detected in the fuel additive system. Let's start the guided diagnosis, which allows us to carry out guided procedures for all the errors. We'll choose the first error. We can see that the guided diagnosis is available, and we reach a page with an overview of all the additional information available. Once we choose the error P200AD to start the guided diagnosis procedure, we must enter the detailed vehicle variant. There are three electrical tests suggested for the selected error, and they're needed for the reducing agent injector, the reducing agent control unit, the reducing agent pump unit. Let's start checking the dosing injector for the AdBlue additive. There are three suggested tests. The injector solenoid check, the pin 1 connection check, the pin 2 connection check. Let's analyze the location of these components to run the tests using the multimeter. The component is highlighted in the picture of the engine. Now we have to press on the wiring diagram tab. This way we can reach the image with its location. Once we have found the engine control unit, we must search for the connector pinout to identify the pins required for the electrical tests. Using the search function for the connector terminals in the ECU connector tab, we'll find the location of pins B74 and B91. For this component, all the electrical tests indicated in the guided diagnosis have passed. All the values are within the ranges required. Let's move on to the next component in the list and perform the tests on the reducing agent control unit. We have to check the power supply to the reducing agent control unit as indicated in IDC5. In this case, we will notice that there is no 12-volt supply voltage on the control unit, pin 1. The tests lead us to check the fuse SF3. For this test, the HaynesPro database shows us the location of the fuse and its characteristics if we press the location button. There is no 12-volt supply voltage in this point either. Let's disconnect the fuse and check its continuity. It is cut off. We must replace it with a new one of equal amperage, 30 ampere. Now we will switch on the instrument panel and notice that the errors will clear right away. The guided diagnosis included in the database and perfectly integrated in IDC5 allowed us to identify and solve the problem quickly and accurately, a real advantage for us and our customers. Follow us on our channels to be always up to date with all the latest news from the world of TEXA.